guys, it's Ishani, aka Total Makeup Junkie 101. So today I have a MAC Tartan Tail collection haul for you guys. This is part one of two hauls because MAC released their chapter one of the Tartan Tail yesterday, which was October 28th. I only had the chance to go today, October 29th, so I went and I picked up a couple of things. I didn't pick up too much, which is good because I told myself I wasn't going to pick up too much because Venomous Villains really hit me bad and I picked up a lot of stuff from that collection. Overall, I don't think that this collection got as much hype as I think MAC would have liked, especially on YouTube, because I haven't seen very many haul videos on this collection. And the main reason why I think that is because Venomous Villains, like, literally just came out. People are still recovering from that collection, and then MAC throws another huge collection at us, and we're just like, I can't take it anymore. So yeah, I ended up picking 7 things from this collection, which is not bad considering it's big. There were eyeshadows, dazzle glass creams, there were a couple of blushes, there were Pearl Glide eyeliners, and then they released their eyeshadow palettes as well. Next week, they're going to be releasing Chapter 2, which has the lip gloss sets and the pigment sets. So I will be hauling some things from that collection, and I'll show you that next week. This haul is going to be structured very similarly to how I did my Venomous Villains haul, in that I'm going to not only show you the products, but I'm going to show you products that I have in my current MAC collection that I think are sort of similar or that are dupes, or that you guys might think are dupes but really aren't. So I'll show you guys similar products as well. Oh, and one other thing that I'm kind of ashamed to tell you guys at the end. I bought one other Venomous Villains item. And I think I'm pretty justified in getting it though, and I'll explain why that is at the end. So yeah, there's one other thing from the Venomous Villains collection that I picked up. This is the last thing. I feel like I'm going back in time now, you know. It's like Venomous Villains hit bad and then I felt like I'm moving forward and now I'm going back in time. Anyways, I'll talk about that at the end and tell you why I got that and all that jazz. So let's just get started with the collection. So the first thing that MAC released in this new Tartan Tail collection are these new eyeshadows, and this is what they look like. I believe MAC calls them their Tartan eyeshadows. They have a really cute printing on the top. I believe the printing goes away as you use it. In these eyeshadows, you are getting 3 grams of product, which is double the amount you're getting in a normal eyeshadow. And these are $19.50. So you're only spending $5 more than a normal eyeshadow, but you're getting double the amount of product. So these are definitely worth it for the money. Now, this first shade that I have here is called Glamora Castle. Temptalia describes this as a steel blue with a silver sheen, which is really what it is. It's just like a steel gray blue. It's really pretty. The closest thing I have to this, which is not really even that close, but it's Club eyeshadow. Club is sort of a greeny, browny, gray shade, depending on the way you look at it. And here are those two swatched. This one on my middle finger is the one from this collection, Glamora Castle, and the one on my pointer finger is Club. So you can see Club is darker, and it definitely has a lot more of that duochrome-y quality to it. You can see like sort of that teal shimmer running through it. So the next eyeshadow I got is this one. This is called Enviably Fun, and Temptalia describes this as a chartreuse green with strong gold sheen and yellow undertones. It's really cute, really pretty. I didn't really have anything exactly like this. And the last one I got is this one. This is called Follow Your Fantasy. Temptalia describes this as a soft orange with a golden sheen, which is really what it is. It's a really pretty corally orange color. Now, the main reason that I got these two eyeshadows is because it really, really reminded me of this trio that I got from the In the Groove collection. And this is the trio. It's called In the Groove. And here are those three compared. So I thought the Follow Your Fantasy looked like this corally orange color here. And I thought the Enviably Fun kind of looked like this greeny color here. And they really do look pretty similar, but these eyeshadows, the ones in this collection, are more pigmented than the mineralized ones, and obviously you're getting way more product. Now, you're probably wondering, okay, if you thought you had the same ones, why did you get these big ones? It's because I love this combination. I love the combination of the peach, the green, and like this taupey brown color. I think I have a taupey brown similar to this. Yeah, so I just kind of wanted to recreate this trio, but just in, like, bigger form, because I love this trio and I feel like I'm gonna run out really quick. Okay, and here we have all of those swatched. So the top one here, this is Enviably Fun from this collection, and that is compared to this one from the In the Groove trio. That's the greeny color in the trio. Then this is the more corally orange color in the trio, and here at the bottom is Follow Your Fantasy from this collection. Yeah, like I said earlier, the single shadows, the ones in this collection, are more pigmented than the ones in the trio, but the shades are very similar. Okay, then MAC promoted three pigments in this collection. One of the pigments was a repromo, and two were brand new shades. So I had to get all three because you guys know I'm like a pigment junkie. So the first shade, which was the repromote, this is called Later. And this is a repromote from the Alice and Olivia collection. Now, all three of the pigments in this collection are very dark, vampy, black-based pigments. So if you don't like those dark colors, I wouldn't recommend these for you. Okay, so Later is a like black-based purple with like a bluish and purple glitter to it. It's really, really pretty. I think Timtalia said that it was sort of similar to My Dark Magic eyeshadow, the purpley side of My Dark Magic. Now, you're not going to be able to tell in the container, but I'm going to do wet swatches for you guys right now. And here are those two swatched next to each other. This one here is the My Dark Magic, the purple side of the My Dark Magic duo, and this one is the pigment in Later. So you can see they're not the same. My Dark Magic is way more like a bright violet purple, and Later is more of like that blue-toned purple. My Dark Magic is way more glittery, and you guys can't really see that in the camera, but it's so much more glittery. And Later is more of like that fine shimmer to it. So they're not really the same. I guess they're comparable, but they're not the same. The next pigment I got is called the Family Crest, and this is obviously another dark vampy shade. This is like a blackened purpley base with a ton of golden and like violet colored shimmer to it. It is so pretty. And one of my subscribers asked me whether this pigment looked like a grease paint stick that came out in the Venomous Villains collection. The grease paint stick is called French Quarter. So let me do a swatch of that for you. So here are those two swatched. The top one here is the Family Crest pigment, and the bottom one here is French Quarter grease paint stick. So they're not really the same. I guess they're kind of the same shade of like that deep black, but the Family Crest has way more golden shimmer to it, and maybe even use French Quarter as a base, and it'll help bring out like the blackened gold in the Family Crest. I think that would be really, really pretty. So I can't wait to use these two together. I think that would be a gorgeous combination. And the last one I got is this one. This is called Moonlit Night, and this is like a dark charcoal gray base with like teal and green shimmer in it. It is so pretty. Don't have anything like this in my collection, so I can't really compare this to anything, but this is absolutely beautiful. And then the last thing I got from this collection is one eyeshadow palette. This is what it looks like. I basically got it because I needed something with this tartan packaging on it. I thought it was really, really cute. To be honest, I didn't feel like a lot of the things were really unique, but neither is this palette. It's not very unique, but it's pretty and I would use it, so that's why I got it. This is called the Six Beauties Play It Cool eyeshadow palette. And this is what the inside looks like. And I'm going to flip it upside down so I don't blind you. And it has a little brush. I don't know what brush this is. I don't know. It doesn't even say MAC on the brush. It just says China. Alrighty then. But here are the six shadows that come in this palette. So I'm not going to go through the names of all of these simply because I don't want to take up your time. Honestly, this isn't that unique of a palette. I got it mostly because I wanted something in the packaging and because I love, love, love purples. The purples in here are beautiful. It had four palettes, but I didn't feel like any of the other ones were must-haves for me. This one was just really nice. And Timtalia said that the pigmentation is fairly good on this palette. She said two of the other palettes lacked pigmentation severely. And the other palette that had good pigmentation, that one was the one with, like, the silvers and the golds and stuff. And I have plenty of silvers and golds. I just didn't need any more. So I got this one. I thought it was pretty. All right, so that's everything I picked up from the collection. Like you can see, small haul, didn't get too much. I really just got the things that I thought were really unique. There were a couple of blushes. There was a hot pink blush. It really reminded me of this one that I already have. This is called Full Fuchsia. It's a permanent pro blush, but it also came out riveting. It's probably not the same hot pink, but this is a really intense hot pink. That one was a really intense hot pink. I don't know how many really intense hot pinks I need because I don't use this color too much. There were also some Pearl Glide liners. I do recommend picking those up if you don't have them. I already had all of them from Art Supplies. They did have two new colors, but I didn't pick them up. But these are the two from the collection that I already had. If you guys don't have these, definitely recommend getting them. There is Petrol Blue, which is a gorgeous blue color, and this one is Undercurrent, which is a gorgeous teal green. And here are those two swatched. The top one is Petrol Blue, the bottom one is Undercurrent. Stunning, stunning shades. They both do have glitter in them. All of the Pearl Glides have glitter in them, so they're not waterline safe, so just beware of that. I mostly use it just on my lower lash line when I want a pop of color. These glide on so smoothly. They're unbelievably pigmented and unbelievably smooth. If you guys don't have them, I do recommend picking at least one of them up. Nothing else really sparked my interest, to be honest with you. There were some really pretty lipsticks, but they weren't really unique. There were some really pretty dazzle glass creams, but I don't buy dazzle glasses or dazzle glass creams simply for the fact that you're not getting very much product for your money, and I'm very against that. So I just didn't get them. I didn't feel like any of the dazzle glasses were so unique that I needed them. What else was there? There were some brush sets and stuff, but I don't buy holiday brush sets. That's pretty much it. I mean, it was an okay collection. Definitely was not my favorite, not the one I would recommend going crazy over. There are some really nice collections coming up really soon, so in my opinion, you can get a couple things from the collection, but nothing was really a must-have. And then, like I said in the beginning of this video, I got one more thing from Venomous Villains. I know it feels like I'm going back in time. I should be moving forward and recovering from this collection, not going back to it. But I had to go back for this eyeshadow. It's from the Evil Queen collection. It's called Vainglorious. It's a frost finish shadow. So this is what it looks like. It's a really pretty sort of purpley, burgundy, red, and plum shade. It's really, really pretty. I didn't get it the first time simply because I knew that this color was coming out in one of the eyeshadow palettes. It was another eyeshadow palette. I didn't actually end up getting the eyeshadow palette simply because when I saw Timtalia's swatches, the colors were so sheer, and she even said herself the Vainglorious in the palette was way less pigmented than the Vainglorious in single form. And so the only reason I didn't get it in single form was because I knew it was coming out in the palette, and since the one in the palette wasn't as good quality and I just didn't want the other sheer colors in the palette, I just figured, you know what, I'll just get it singly. Luckily my MAC counter still had it, and yeah, so I just got this. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That is my MAC Tartan Tail Chapter 1 haul. I will have a Chapter 2 haul up for you guys next week. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye!